first I was always, I think, since I'm small, a bit obsessed by the problem. I remember that I saw the movie M from Fritz Lang about a pedophile. And I remember that it took me years and years to be able to watch the movie. I just could watch the first images and then I would cry or scream or and go away. So M was something quite important in my life. Then I remember telling myself that the rapers, they have nowhere to speak. And my grandmother, she used to tell me, in life, or you do or you speak. You have to do one or the other. So I thought, how can a raper not rape? Because I never heard about or never read about a happy raper. I mean, you have happy criminal, happy people who are stealing. I mean, at least at one moment of their life, they can be happy. The end is generally bad, but you don't have a happy raper. And so I thought, how can we create a space to speak so there would be less rapes? And then that was in my mind. And on the other hand, there was a young actor that I saw in a movie of Amos Gitai who was speaking Yiddish absolutely fluently, and he was 20. And I did not understand how can a young boy like that speak Yiddish, which is, the producer used to say, it's not a dead language, it's the language of the dead. And and then I saw him in another film, which was a documentary film called Pork and Milk, about young people who left the Orthodoxy, the Jewish Orthodoxy, and he was one of them. And I realized in general how hard it was to leave the Orthodoxy. And in the movie he said that he was Nettori Carta. Nettori Carta for me was like devil. It's really like the darkest of the darkest Orthodox, Jewish Orthodox. But on the other hand, he showed a picture where that he had from his family, that it was so, they were smiling so much. I could not I thought between this smile and the idea I had from those people, there was something. Then I always decide that if I'm going to do a movie in Israel, which is I'm going to do now, I will propose him a small role. And so I called him to meet him. And before going there, I did something that I never do. I put his name on the internet, and then there's a blog coming saying about kids, Jewish kids that had been raped in the Orthodox community. So then I understood why I was always so moved by him. And then I saw also on the blog a small film that he did with a hidden camera, where he filmed one of his rapers, who said, yes, I did that, but who, was speaking about that. And I thought he was doing a movie, so I told him, if you want, maybe we can help you in producing this movie. And he said, no, but it was 10 years ago, and I received so many threats, I stopped it. And then he called me, like, let's do it. So I began to do it, and the Yiddish, which was for me so moving, because I speak a bit of Yiddish. I used to speak that with my grandma. And my Yiddish is not good, but it was good enough to understand and to be in the movie and to calm also any aggressivity. Each time there would be somebody aggressive, I would say a sentence in Yiddish, and they would be okay. And I must say that it was quite magic and easy to do this film. It seems really difficult for the people who watch it, like, because it's a forbidden word normally, but it's really like everybody opened up so much, and it was nearly magic. In a certain way, the aim of the movie is, the aim and the dream of the movie is to make the stories of rape banal, but like death is banal, but it's terrible. Rape is the same thing. It's banal, but it's terrible. And the so if you think it's banal, you put the you know, you share it with so many people, and there's also a lot of dimensions in which are in the movie, like the pleasure, like a lot of things that, you know, can make somebody not want to talk about it. In the film, at the end we were like a club. it was strange. It was nearly joyful to be able to stand up with that and to try to without judgment, because there's even a guy who arrived one night on the port of Jaffa, which is really strange because it was the Arab city, and we see this guy coming with pious and everything, and he says that he has been raped and that he raped also, and he speaks about it, and he says how he went to see the family of the boy he has raped, and to break his galgal, his circle, so the boy won't be like him. And all the other ex-kids, I mean, they are the people I film are between 19 and 35, look at him like a hero. Don't look at him with judgment. Look at him like a hero, that he could face his story, that he could go, and they all say, if my rapper could have gone to my father and say, I'm sorry what I did to your son, my life would have been different. And so it puts all the those, and also, the people speak about everything. They speak about sexuality, they speak, they're even quite funny when they speak all that. I mean, Sarajevo is a quite strong name. It is something in the heart. And so there is something where also my heart is a bit like, you know, I can feel also I'm very sensitive to architecture or to the archaeology which exists in the buildings, or so I can feel a lot of things that had happened. So of course, and it's quite a mythic name also, because I mean it was always, so it's very strong, to be here. And I must say also that I'm very happy because I made my first feature film, was quite a long time ago, and it was the first year of the festival, of the Sarajevo Film Festival. It was the last year of the war, and they asked it for some people called me, and I was not in France to send it, and I always felt so sorry. So now when I received the phone call of Sarajevo, I said yes, of course.